Oh man, I don't want to hit this. Oh, this is not good. That was close. So there's Griffin around the mark. Please don't go down. Thank you.
We got Joe Bice up here in front. He's leading the pack.
Ow!
Hey guys, this is Lee Montes. Happy New Year. Today is the Ice Cube Regatta at Sea Cliff Yacht Club in Sea Cliff, New York, Long Island. This is like the usual frostbiting thing. It's about 52 to 53 degrees, nice flat water, and got 2, 4, 6. This is a casual racing, even though it's pretty competitive. We're sailing sunfishes and about 7 or 8 lasers. So if you're ever thinking about sailing and racing in the winter, this is how it is, always is. Hey guys, this is Lee here. If you could do me a favor and smash that like button, I'd really appreciate it. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe to the channel. It's completely free and it helps out the channel a lot. Have you ever thought about sailing in the winter and frostbiting? Leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you.
I'm wearing a spray top and some spray pants, life jacket, of course. We have a crash boat out there, support boat. And it's actually pretty warm. Don't get me wrong. A lot of people are here in dry suits, but it is a little bit warm, so I decided to come out here. They have the Ice Cube Regatta. It's definitely not in the freezing conditions, but sometimes it gets a little cold out here. And we're waiting for them to shift the course around because it went from the west and now it's going to the north, so they're shifting around to get a nice course, which is square to the wind. Right there, the sunfish fleet is waiting. We have like 16 sunfish out here and about 8 lasers. Got a bunch of juniors out here. We got Jim Cole from the dinghy shop is out here helping. He helped rig a few boats today. And Doug Weffer is the fleet captain for the Sea Cliff Yacht Club. And it's a beautiful day. It's like, I'm not even wearing gloves here. A lot of people are wearing their winter gear, which is prudent. It's a good time to wear your dry suits because it is getting, the water's kind of cold. So if you do fall in, it'll keep you safe. So right now, generally speaking, when they start the races, they'll do dinghy starts, which is a 3-minute dinghy start. And that's a warning for the warning, which will be 3 minutes, 3 long. So they're gonna sail the lasers right now. If anyone wants to try frostbiting, they have several fleets across the country that do it. I know the MOBYC, Man Overboard Yacht Club, down in New Bern, North Carolina. They have their Hot Toddy series on Sundays. Sonia Dean is a big member down there, so is Rob Eberly. And they sail in cold weather when it gets down to like 65, 70 degrees. So they rough it out and they put their dry suits on when it gets down to 60. And they're one of the original fleets, and they were actually part of a movie called Frostbiters, where they showed the frostbiting fleets across the country, like Newport, the famous laser fleet down there, and Barrington, Rhode Island. They showed the Frosty fleet up, I think, in Massachusetts or Maine. I'm sure there's a whole bunch of quote-unquote frostbite fleets down south in Florida. I know Davis Island sails all year round and Sarasota. What's really cool about frostbiting is that you got some really die-hard sailors out there, and the wind conditions are much different from your normal conditions from the summer. It gives you a lot of good practice on sailing shifts, different types of wind, different wind speeds. It puts you in a mindset where you're thinking about not falling in as much and dressing appropriately. But the people out here, generally speaking, the frostbiting sailors, they're really itching to go sailing. So they go sailing when it gets cold and you have to shovel snow off your boat sometimes. Out in the Midwest, sometimes they can't frostbite because their water gets frozen. so don't go ice boating. I'm gonna leave some links down in the description below so you can find out more about frostbiting and sailing in general. So check out the description down below.
Okay, so they shifted the start line from here to here. So what's nice about this day today, Sea Cliff Yacht Club hosts every Sunday they have frostbiting, but in certain days and holidays, like the Turkey Trot, Ice Cube Regatta, the Heartbreak Regatta for Valentine's Day, and also the April Fool's Regatta, they'll have an event where they have an entry fee and they'll give out prizes for the sailors. So it's a lot of fun.
Not good. I kind of got myself in here.
You do me a favor, could you just push me off there as I bash into a crash boat? Thank you. Oh, thank you.
That's what happens when you try to use your phone. And
all right, so this is the view from the race committee. So this is like a social club here. They hang out. Some parents are here, some sailing fans. The lasers are jockeying for position.
Looks like the pin is favored, according to the lasers here. All right.
So what's nice about having a fleet start in front of you, you could watch them and you don't have to do any starting line work. I'm gonna get out of here before I...
2:15 to the start. I don't know even what the course is.
It's Doug Weffer in a 16 boat. He's checking out the line. If you're near Doug or in front of Doug, you're in pretty good position. That's all you need to know.
It got a little windy here. Oh, some white caps up there.
He's adjusting the line.
Let's see what he does.
I have no clue what's going on here. We got 1:10 to go.
I guess the two yellow marks there is 1 minute.
Chop it right there.
Oh boy, this is gonna be difficult.
What is going on?
I don't know where's the start line?
Is that yellow mark the start line?
I guess so.
Oh, I guess I'm the start. Okay, I'm over.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, that was a terrible start. It's Facebook Live, and you better look good.
Okay, let's see how Joe.
Gonna pinch me out.
I got you on video.
Oh, he's pointing right.
All right, y'all. You're. All right. So I'm sailing basically one-handed. Yeah.
All right.
We got Joe Bysh up here in front. He's leading the pack, and we got Griffin Sisk here. He's going to back there. Doug. My left arm is getting tired.
All right, so this is a weird race course because it really looks like we could almost like one tack this. We're gonna have to tack at least once. I'm in bad air here, but since we're pointing towards the mark, kinda, I'm not gonna tack it.
So they're gonna be tacking soon. Then Joe's gonna tack soon. Well, it looks like Griffin took the lead there.
So there's Griffin around the mark.
Please don't go down. Thank you.
Oh, this is getting hairy.
The wind just picked up. I'm
gonna tack around this mark.
Flip this. Flip. All right, here we go.
I wonder if it's once around or twice.
Oh, Doug lost his rig. I wonder if he broke his rig.
Look, whoa, diving.
Gotta switch this.
All right, so Doug lost his rig. He either lost his halyard or his mast broke. My guess is, I don't all I see is men.
This mask broke up. Maybe I should pay attention.
We got Jim Cole right here in a 4-7 boat. No idea if it's a once around or first round.
I've lost a lot of boat.
We got Griffin going in first with the 0 number. Joe Beisch in the 79587. Oh my God, it looks like they're going around a gate. We're still racing. All right, we're still racing. All right, we're gonna try to do this again. Oh no. Oh, okay. So they're calling this line from here. This is the pin and the dock is the finish line. Okay, so Griffin took that, Joe took second. Let's turn around here. Okay, and then Jim's fourth. I better clear this line. So in order to finish, you gotta clear the line. Ow! Okay, here we go. Nice. I wanna get hit. We got Liam Flanagan from Wet Pants Sailing Association. Hey Liam, how old are you? 14. 14, you sound really well. In 2021, he sailed in the New York State Regional, did really well. One of the top juniors out there. It's a beautiful day. You can see Connecticut across the Long Island Sound all the way back. He broke his mast or his boat or something. So he's getting towed in. So that's really good that we have a support boat. Frostbite sailing basically is really short courses. And you can play multiple races. Yeah, so Frostbite sailing is run between 4, 5, 6, 7 races on really short courses. The courses range from 10 to 15 minutes long. You keep moving and the race committee, they're on the ball. They will race as many races in the amount of short time possible. So you get in and out of the water. You're not spending too much time waiting around. But since we have two fleets, we are rating in between because they have a nice laser fleet. Not really little, it's like 7. Not like the Newport fleet, but the Newport fleet is legendary. So they get their own start. They usually get their own start if they have like 3 boats or more. Beautiful day, huh? So most of the laser sailors are sailing with some sort of Mark II type of laser. That's a Neil Pride sail right there. And that's a Neil Pride sail. That's an APS sail, and there's a laser sail there. Generally speaking, most people break out, if they have the luxury, they'll break out their frostbiting gear, frostbiting sails. Right now, I'm sailing the Red Rocket sail. My friend Kenny's daughter painted the flames on the Sunfish there, and the sail is actually pretty good, even though it's a little bit soft. It works, and my other sail was taken off because when I went down to Miami, I didn't have it rigged. So thank God I had this sail already rigged. So I didn't have to rig a sail yesterday. There's one thing you should know. You see that? You see how my halyard is, I'm too lazy to tighten it up. So now the deck, it's like a half an inch off the deck. The laser's gonna start. They're not very aggressive on the start line. They give each other a nice lot of room. The 606 boat started to the leeward. That's the 984 boat. So that's a very powerful position on starting, is to start to the leeward with a lot of water to your left. Racing in tight quarters with a phone in a hand is a little goofy. Okay, when you feel like you're going slow, check your centerboard for weeds. Going real slow. There's these reeds hanging out. So I dropped down to fourth. Griffin Sis just took off. Jim Kohler's second. Joe Bice is third. I'm presently in fourth. Let's flip this around. Right on my tail here. Good race, Joe. Fifth, sixth. Yeah, it doesn't matter what place you're going. It's a lot of fun. There's the rest of the fleet here. It's beautiful sailing. Here we are at Sea Cliff Yacht Club in Sea Cliff, Long Island, Glen Cove area, North Shore, Long Island. Probably about half hour away from New York City, maybe 40 minutes. Depends on the traffic, of course. And traffic is terrible. So today we had about 15, 16 boats. A lot of juniors, it's awesome, awesome to see. So seriously, if you guys ever want to sail in the winter, try to find a fall series or just sail in the fall. In the winter, it is a different animal though, because it can get dangerous. So for instance, there's a crash boat here or a support boat. There's other sailors out here. I would not suggest sailing alone in the winter, especially if the water is cold, just in case the part breaks on your boat and you're kind of stuck. But it's a lot of fun. You don't have to race seriously. You learn a lot. I hope you liked that video. So if you liked that video, check out this video right here. And I'm sure you'll like that one too. And I'd appreciate it if you smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you on the water.